This month on What's New on EDU.
And three, two.
Welcome to What's New in EDU, the place to learn about new updates and features coming from Microsoft Education.
This month you'll learn about upcoming events, new devices, and exciting announcements from OneNote. But first, a new experience launched in Windows 10 called Story Remix. Here's Chris and Emily.
Thanks, Frank. I'm Emily.
And I'm Chris.
Story Remix is a video editor that we're making with education usage in mind. So we want to make sure that it works really well for students and teachers for things like collaborative video projects, lab reports, and we want to make sure that it works really well with the systems that are already in use in classrooms, like Office 365 for Education. We also want to make sure that kids can have the lowest barrier to entry possible, so we're going to make it work with the mobile devices they already have in their pockets.
Their iPhones and Android phones.
Exactly.
Right. And Story Remix is not just a regular video editor. We decided to go and reinvent the concept of video editing using artificial intelligence as an assistant. So with Story Remix, you can give it video footage and still images, and it will put together for you a realistic, reasonable video automatically within a couple of seconds with music.
And we're really excited to get feedback from new users as well. So if you want to start trying it out with early versions of the app, you can do that by getting on the Windows Insider program in the control panel in Windows 10, or it'll be available to the world for free in Windows 10 as part of the Fall Creators Update.
Oh, and it also includes really cool Hollywood special effects. You can put 3D effects into it, particles, fires, explosions. Kids love that stuff.
Chris Prattley is also the original engineer on another app you know and love, OneNote. This month, OneNote got a significant update that makes it even easier for anyone to express themselves digitally. Welcome to the redesigned OneNote. The OneNote team announced in mid-May that they were updating the design of OneNote for Windows 10, Mac, iOS, Android, and OneNote Online. These design features, all based on user feedback and rolling out over the coming weeks, include three key areas of focus. Enhancing usability for those who use assistive technologies. This is great especially for special education teachers who have students who need screen readers and can easily navigate through the app. Simplifying navigation controls. Content is front and center, even for larger notebooks like class notebooks, helping students to focus and avoid distractions. Creating consistency across the devices. This makes it easier for teachers and students to easily transition between home and school devices or browser and app versions. Just like OneNote, learning tools, once a OneNote add-in, is now becoming something with global reach to help all students. Immersive Reader helps anyone on any device improve their reading skills, including people with dyslexia, dysgraphia, ADHD, as well as English language learners. With the recent announcement, we are helping to bring improved comprehension and independent reading to more applications and new languages.
I have a dyslexic student who's also dysgraphic. He still reads on a kindergarten level. You know, he's 10 years old, he's still learning sight words, and you know, he would tell me all the time that he was stupid. When we started the school year, he read 4 words per minute. And when we got the learning tools with the immersive reader, he went to 22 words per minute. I never thought in one calendar school year that we would even get into double digits. And he's at 22 words per minute, and he stayed there.
Try it now on the new learning tools webpage, even if you don't have a Microsoft or Office 365 account.
We know from talking with so many of you that it's important for Microsoft technology to just work with investments you've already made for your school, especially your student information systems and your learning management systems. Since spring of last year, teachers have been able to give assignments and grade them in Class Notebook and then just have them show up in their SIS or LMS. With this month's edition of Blackbaud on Campus and eSchool Data, the number of SIS and LMS partners integrating with Class Notebook is now at 40 and growing. There are guides online to get you started with your SIS or LMS, so check out the link. There are also great new devices from our partners that are affordable and have a ton of features like touchscreen, inking, and long battery life. We'll highlight a new device from time to time here on What's New in EDU. So here's this month's spotlight device, the TravelMate Spin B1 from Acer. First of all, I want to show you the adaptive 360-degree hinge so it can easily transform from laptop to tent to tablet. It's a touchscreen too, and it has inking, so you can draw, write, and solve math problems directly on the screen, just like pen and paper. It's able to withstand the everyday rigor of the classroom and protects against accidental bumps and drops with a pressure-resistant screen, and it can handle the rain. 4 gigabytes memory, 64 gigabytes of storage, up to 13 hours of battery life, an 11.6 inch high def display, and it comes in under $299. The Acer TravelMate Spin B1 is just one of several new devices from our OEM partners with pricing that starts at $189 or $279 with ink. Amazing prices. So we'll continue to highlight different devices on this show, but if you just can't wait to see them, check out the link and browse them all today.
Finally, there's a big event coming up for us here at Microsoft Education. And Lindsay, my friend and our marketing manager, is ready to tell us more about it.
That's right, ISTE 2017 is right around the corner. And we have the exciting opportunity this year to invite all of our global educators and our global educator community to join us live from the event in San Antonio on Tuesday, June 27th. You can tune in live to Hack the Classroom. We'll be live from 5 to 7 Central, but you can also tune in on Facebook Live or on demand later. Back to you, Frank.
Also at ISTE, we'll have some great sessions to help IT and tech advocates learn how to set up their classroom PCs in just about an hour. Even if you can't attend, don't worry, we've got you covered. We have all the deployment resources available for you online. So that's it for us here. Thanks for joining us on this month's What's New in EDU. Check out our blog for more details and links to everything you heard here. Share this episode with your fellow educators and administrators. We'll let students wrap it up for us. Tweet us if you want your students to appear on a future episode of What's New in EDU.
See you.